Hi, this is Sumit and you are watching Knowledge Modulation. Friends, today in this video, we are going to learn about networking because if you are going to face some interviews and you are fresher, so you may get confused that what types of question will be asked by the interviewer. So in this video, we will cover all these topics, and without wasting time, let's continue to the video. As you are going to face the network engineer interview, your first question may be, what is a LAN? LAN is a short form of local area network. But at the time of interview, you have to explain what is LAN. Basically, it is a short network which connects all the computer devices along with other networking devices like switches and hub. Suppose there is one office and all office infrastructure is covered by a LAN. So you may define as a work network. This is a LAN network. The second question is, what is the basic difference between normal LAN cable and crossover cable? Nowadays, there are switches and routers which are intelligent devices, but previously, if you want to connect the similar devices, you have to connect them with the cross cable. Nowadays, you may connect these devices by a simple LAN with the RJ45 cable. They are intelligent devices, so they can easily identify the end device. So they can communicate with each other easily. Next question is, what is DHCP? It is a dynamic host control protocol. Sometimes you open your mobile hotspot. So at that time, the friend which is using your hotspot, he gets an automatic IP address. So this scheme comes under DHCP because your mobile offers one IP address to your friend's device. So same configuration does everywhere where we install the DHCP server and all. A simple router also do all these things. So this is a basic concept of DHCP to offer a valid IP address. The next one is, what is an Active Directory? A central component of the Windows platform. Active Directory service provides the means to manage the identities and relationship that make up network environments. For example, we can create, manage, and administrator user computers and printers in the network from Active Directory. Active Directory is a centralized system from where we can control all the users from our network, also computers and printers. All entries are saved at the Active Directory, and permissions and all the things are maintained by Active Directory. So next question is, what is DNS? In DNS, there are two main questions. What is forward lookup and the reverse lookup? So we'll discuss in detail. DNS is basically domain name service. The name itself defines what work it does. When you type google.com, basically google.com has its particular IP address. So google.com connect to that particular IP address, and this connection linking between this name and the IP resolution is done by the DNS only. The first point is forward lookup. When you type google.com, it's redirected to one particular IP address. So it is the forward lookup. And reverse lookup is when you enter one IP address. Suppose you know you are the google.com's IP address and you directly put your IP address, and then it directly connect to the redirect to the google.com. So this is the reverse lookup. Next one is, what is APIPA IP address? When DHCP server is not available, the Windows client computer assigns an automatic IP address to itself so that it can communicate with the network computers. This IP address is called APIPA. This IP address starts with the 169. Suppose you are getting the IP address 169. Dot something, then you may conclude that your DNS server is not responding. So if you are using the client's computer, you have to go to the services and you have to restart the DNS services. It may help you to resolve your issues. The next question is, what is difference between domain and workgroup? Domain is created when we install Active Directory. It's a security boundary which is used to manage computers inside the boundary. Domain can be used to centrally administer computers, and we can govern them using common policies called group policies. We can't do the same with workgroup. So in simple, if you install Active Directory or if you have Active Directory, then your network is must be in domain or it's already in domain. If you are working with a workgroup, then it is not in domain. So if you want to manage the users and groups and the permissions centrally, you have to move to the domain only. Otherwise, if you want to share just network on the file storage and all, you may continue with the workgroup. The next question is, what is PST and difference between PST and OST file? You may well known about Outlook. So when we use Outlook, all the file gets saved. We can say that the cache are saved to remote desktop. The file which save all this cache is in format of PST format. When you move from server, all the files stored to your remote computer. At that time, these files are saved as a OST file. Next question is, what is VPN? VPN is a virtual private network. Suppose in case you have to work with your company and company is situated at different location. So for the security purpose and you have to connect your computer from your location to the company location, you need one particular link to connect computer to access some servers from company. So at that time VPN comes in use. There are lots of companies which provides the VPN, and you also define your VPN, and also routers are very good to define the VPN servers. The next question is, what is difference between switches and hub? Nowadays hubs are not used because switches are working the next layer to the hub, because switches are very intelligent switches and they know which traffic where to pass. So hub is not intelligent. He doesn't know where traffic to send, because hub sends traffic to all the ports and switch know where to send. Basically switches are very useful, and nowadays only switches are in use. The next question is, what is router? The switches and the routers are the most important devices you have to learn, and you must know each and everything about the routers. What does router? The router passes this traffic. It uses the multiple protocols to send this traffic, like ARP, EIGRP, BGP protocols and OSPF concept. By using all these concepts, router communicate to the other network and route this traffic to particular location. What is the difference between LAN and WAN? If you have one office situated at a particular floor, so it comes under a LAN configuration. When it gets to some large partitions, it comes under the wide area network. It covers the larger area than a LAN area. Next one is the difference between client main and webmail. Email clients download your emails into your computer using a specialized email program such as Outlook Express or Apple Mails, has the advantage of giving you complete control over your email. Every email you receive is placed on your computer and you can keep as many large files that attachment as you want. Checking your email through a webmail is similar to using Hotmail or Yahoo Mail. You never actually copy your message to your computer. In fact, you are looking at them through your web browser on somebody's else computer. When you are not online, you are not able to see your emails. Nowadays, we are using the Outlook, and similarly, Zoho Mails, Simbra Mails, all these mail servers are used by the clients, because when you send one message, it directly saved to your computer in the form of cache. Previously I told you that PST file and the OST file, the same format, all the mails are saved at your personal device like computers, and you may configure this on your mobile also. But as example, google.com, when you connect to the internet, then only you can access your mails, otherwise not. So this is the main difference between client mail and web mail. The next question is DNS. Previously also we discussed about the DNS, but again we'll discuss in deep. DNS is domain name services. When you try to connect to some particular website, you directly hit the website name. Suppose you purchased one domain from the godaddy.com. So godaddy.com has its DNS for the google.com, and or maybe you purchase some domain. So for that domain, the domain provider has the DNS. So DNS has to link with your hosting place. At the back end, they will get linked, and then only whole thing is processed. This is a deep process, but for now, the DNS is the domain name service that converts the name to the IP address and IP address to the name. It will help you to directly remember any website name, and you can hit the website and directly connect to the particular site. For the private sectors also, if you have large number of computers in your offices, suppose there are 200 computers over there, and for them there are four departments, like management department, sales department, IT department and business department. So for the all department, there are 50 computers over there. So you can create one DNS server and name all these computer by their department. So it will help to administrator, network administrator or system administrator, to identify the devices. Suppose one particular person wanted to install some software, you can directly identify which device, on the which device you have to install all this software. So that purpose also, we can manage the DNS server also for our private network. So guys, this is all for this video for today, and we will going to learn more questions in upcoming videos. So if you like all these videos, please hit like and also share this video with your friends so they also prepare for their interview very well. And if you wish to watch more videos like this, please subscribe to the Knowledge Modulation and keep watching our videos.